brought a revival in that place. Praise the Lord. So, you can see that picture there now on danger. I love the first one. It says, do not touch. Not only with this key, it will hurt the whole time you are dying. It will hurt the whole time you are dying. That means the end result is bad, but the process is bad also. When they say don't touch fire, don't play with fire. Fire will burn the person. The more adversity play with fire, the burnt will be severe. When they say 5 degrees, second degree burnt. The thing is hot, and the person is dying also. There's no, it's not a plain thing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, as a child of God, we must try not to live an unforgiving world life. We must desist from it. That is the essence of this study. For us to live a life that is unforgiving world free. Of forgiveness. Now, look at those pictures now. Both persons refuse to forgive each other. There's communication breakdown. No matter how colorful your life is, because of that unforgiveness, you can't fly. The both of us signify the beauty of your destiny. It wants you and I to walk, to fly higher. That's why the man I gave his testimony, Arctic, can die, that's his name. If you want to fly high, you have to let go. As I said, I forget the past. Pressing ahead. Because a lot of people hurt you along the way. And especially people that are very close to you. That is the funny thing about it. This is always happening to people that are very, very close to you. Very much close to you. That's why Christ will say, if your brother offends you, try and watch him. Because you're surprised that how come you know that he's close to me doing this kind of thing? So God wants you and I to what? To let go so that you can do what? Fly higher and fulfill your destiny. Now, our outline is there. God commands us to forgive, and the consequences of unforgiving attitude. God commands you and I to do what? To forgive you. It's a must. It's a must. If you go through the Lord's Prayer, sorry, man. You can say the Lord's Prayer for us.
What?
Thy will come.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from every evil.
Amen. Now, if you go back now, give us our daily bread. Now, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. So, if you don't forgive, your daily bread will not come. Huh? My wife is shaking her head. Because if you don't forgive now, you will get the full blessing. That is the essence of it. It's deep.
What is daily bread? What is daily bread?
Provision.
So will you tell me that all the time that people hurt you and you need to help for people, you
don't
eat for that period?
Yeah, but we don't get 100%.
I don't understand here. I need to be clarified on that.
You don't get it 100%.
You don't eat 100% or
you don't get the blessing of 100% provision.
It's likely that since she said give up this day, it's likely that if we don't forgive, maybe we are eating what was supposed to, what the leftover from yesterday.
Because it's a daily supply.
It's a daily supply. But since most of us, if we don't go forgive, that means we are not getting the daily supply. But the one that are already left over, that are in our provision or custody, that's what we are eating. And consider what she said on Thursday, that we are still sharing the same testimony of the past. And is that the Christianity for us? You know,
what
that was part of
the prayer. We want to be thriving more. We want to be moving from glory to glory.
The daily bread, is it a physical thing or a spiritual thing?
Both.
It's combined.
Both. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, whenever you commit a sin, God made a provision for you to do or to confess your sin and what be cleansed. And that's why God said, when you forgive, that's why Christ made that saying, to the merciful you shall what? Find mercy. To the merciful you shall find mercy. So when you forgive, you find God to forgive you easily also. And God kind of forgives that when he forgives, he doesn't what? Recall it back. See everything what? Just what? Wipe away. Just wipe away. Now, if you look at this, the text we read from Matthew 18, 21 to 35, the king said, I have forgiven you, I have compassion on you. Why can't you do the same for your fellow servants? Because look at the money. He was owing, I don't know what it in the British pounds now. He was owing £10,000. And his fellow servant was owing just £100. Now, if your boss forgive you of £10,000, that is enough for you to want to even go out and bless people with £1,000. Honestly, because that happened that when people get their debt being wiped out, the little they have, they want to celebrate with others. Ah! My debt will be wiped out too. The little they have, they want to celebrate. That joy. So the king was so surprised that, I haven't done so much for you. You had decided to go and what? To and punish your own fellow servant. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So you can see what Christ said. Said, why can't you forgive your fellow servant? If you look at it, and the king, as the king said, I will put you in jail and your wife. You can see what that was his first part of it. Now, when the king said, okay, I forgive you, he now went to do the same. He put the man in jail. When the king decided to pay him back, the king said, put him in jail, and so would send tormentors to torment him. So he was not times two. So that was times two. Because that is what the scripture says, anything you burn on earth is what burn the end of it. So, not like, what is the name of that minister? Not the founder of Redeem. They said that. The fellow man of God that he tore his tracks, his palm face. Listen, that when he died, there was that all that bitterness that fellow minister has against him. God was sending him back to make peace with him so that he can have his way through. Because there was a record against him that this guy, I'm not happy with him. So God wanted the record to be clean. I will send him back. That is it, men of God. God always make a way to make God they make heaven. Because the enemy tries to what take us down. Can you just imagine a priest called Joshua who put on a fitting garment? Praise the Lord. So the thing is deep. It's deep. That is saying make peace with all men. Make peace with all men. Let's say Mark 11:25. Because the gospel of Jesus is what is forgiveness. Christ came to forgive the world.
Mark 11, 25.
My boy, please.
Yes.
So I tell you, time 25.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, my own is combined. And when you start praying,
yes, sir,
forgive anyone you have anything against. Then your father in heaven will forgive your sin.
No, my boy.
Then 26 again, the other one will 26.
But if you do not forgive, neither will your father which is in heaven forgive your
trespasses. That's Christ talking there for you. So when you are standing, anybody that pulls your mind, just start forgiving them. You have to do that. I have to start calling the names of the people that I forgive you, I forgive you, I forgive you, I forgive you. Because it hurts, honestly. But just have to just obey the scripture. So the ministry of Christ is what is forgiveness. When they brought the woman that committed adultery, and the girl that she used to be stoned to death, say, yeah, your pizza. Say, neither do I accuse you. Christ immediately was to forgive that lady. He said, your sins are forgiven. People say, ah, how can you forgive? So the gospel we are preaching is called forgiveness. It's forgiveness. Because we're going to go out to minister to this people, we have to what? Forgive them, because a lot of things will come to our mind that these people have treated us bad, that colonized us, that did so many things against us, that look at me this way. Honestly, if we have to win them, we have to forgive them. That's like I can have compassion. That was the compassion Christ was preaching. He has forgiveness for man. Because if we don't do that, then we cannot move forward.
Please.
That is a command. It is a command for you and I to do what? To forgive. So that we can preach the gospel effectively and bring men into his kingdom and us to make our lives straight also. So it is a command. It is a command. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, the consequences of unforgiving attitude. You can see that picture there now.
Oh, yes!
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That was the guy, the king, and the servant now. The king is always good.
So
when you open and open, David
is my sister.
The one king, the king, that forgive me initially. Now we have to what? Revoke his word. And when he's doing that, he hands it over to the tormentors. Who are the tormentors?
Devil.
Good.
Dark angels.
Demons.
Demons, yeah.
Dark angels.
Sicknesses.
So you can see. So you can see the tormentors, there are more. Not of tormentors. Tormentors.
That's okay.
Tormentors. You see this, the process there? He put the man in jail. So the person is now in the feast corner. They will now bring in the tormentors. Now, Satan is very good at his job. That does not give the enemy a foothold. If you do that, you will not from his foot, you will not touch a stronghold. So that is the process. Don't. You do that because the unforgiveness opened the door for the enemy to come and torment you. Just open the door.
I know.
So we pray to God that the demon like, woo, what happened? Job. They are very good at their job. They are expert in their job. They are expert in their job. They will deal with that person. To deal with that person. So don't give the enemy a foothold. Let's see Proverbs 11:21.
Though they join forces,
yes,
the wicked will not go unpunished, but the prosperity of the righteous will be delivered.
So let God do the fight for you. Our duty is to what? To report to that person, to God. Because God operates
mercy and judgment. Sometimes God will just let go of the person. Sometimes God says, okay, this person old is too much. You need to use as an example to other wicked people to repent. God will not bring judgment. But sometimes God will not bring mercy to use that person to win others also. Because as I said, the mercy of God, the judgment of God is to bring men to his kingdom. So whatever way God decides to operate, just leave it for God. Let God do it. Not you. Don't try to play God. If you try to play God, you have problems. And the dangers is mine. Dangers is mine. Just leave it for me. The only thing is to either to report to God and let go of faith. Praise the Lord. Pray much and unforgiveness bring harvest of evil deeds done to your offender upon you. So, what is that address?
Coming,
wake up! Now you can see, because when we get in that unforgiving attitude, you are trying to say, want to deal with that person. But literally, you are drinking poison. You are drinking what? Poison. Because we said that at the end that you are having this unforgiving attitude, you're always weighed down. That your heart is always what? Heavy. First picture there. They put them out of his mind. But because that stone, you can't move. So you find yourself, your heart is being what? Heavy. That rage is there. You want to do it. And that will bring heart attack. Because of that thing that's in the heart. Because the heart is deep, it's big, it's small. But what is kind? Massive. So God does not want you to what? To avert that evil deed. Just
ooh, hurry up! Oh no!
So that offender evil do not be upon you. Just leave it. Just leave it. Just imagine what happened to King Saul. The man that said that he was the one that killed Saul last. David said, you kill my father. Saul was an evil man that is was trying to kill David. But that man said, his sins upon you. He just said he was killed. Why?
Why
so just believe it so that the evil deed of that person will not be upon you.
Good.
God said, any man that kills Cain is blood of your father. Cain was already meant to be destroyed. So just leave it. Let that swarm just go. It's an evil person. So don't try to put your hand and let this blood be upon you. Your duty is to pray for him to repent or let judgment cut up with that person. All forgiveness prevents you from benefiting from the cleansing power of Jesus. Now we are praying. God will cleanse you from every infirmity, everything. Now call that bitterness, that unforgiveness. The blood of Jesus didn't work. You have become what infecting in your life. But because of that little thing. Because the accuser of the brethren knows God has not. He's a legal man. He will not stand there. So the blood of Job will not be infected. It will not be infected. Just everything will not be making. It's of no effect. It's of no effect. It will not work. And you are not wasting your time.
It's my.
And he said, leave your gift there. Just reconcile so that things will not flow easily at peace with you, that you now people will not see the change in you. Not see the change in you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now, it makes your gift to the world and rejected by God. Christ said, because that is not in the manner, but I decided to look for it. Matthew 5:22-24. Let me take it.
Whoever is angry with his brother without cause shall be in danger of the judgment, and whoever shall say to his brother Raka shall be in danger of the counting. But whoever says be full shall be in danger of your fire.
Continue.
Therefore, if you bring a gift to the altar and then remember against your brother that your brother has something against you, leave your gift there before the altar and go your way. First be reconciled to your brother and then come back to your gift.
Then come back to you. So God said, oh no, this gift, this prayer, this thanksgiving, let's pause first. Forgive him first. Reconcile with him. I said, ah, yeah, give him free now, at least. Check your heart meter. Forgiveness is there. So when you die, you keep it clean. And then that's the fruit. So that's what Christ is telling us. This is Christ talking to us. That we should do what? Take that thing out of our heart. Let go of it. Let go of it. It happens easily. That's why when you sit down, when you record of it, just say, Lord,
come on, let's go!
Say it. Let your ear hear that you forgive it. Say it loud. Lord, mention the person's name. Mention it. See that things will not work out for you. It hinders your prayers to be answered. In that way, that unforgiveness hinders answers to prayers. Look at Matthew 6:15 then. Memory verse. Say, if they forgive not men that trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. So God will not forgive your trespasses, he cannot answer you. Say, what are what? My hands are not short, neither my ears dead. See, because of what your iniquity. So that is our iniquity now.
Sure.
Well, unforgiveness is part of it. So when there's unforgiveness, God said, I'm not answering you. See, my hand is not short. I'm not dead. I can see clearly. But because of this thing, I can't do anything. So God wants you and I to always what? Have what? A forgiving what? Heart. Forgiving what? Attitude. A forgiving heart. Let it be a part of us. Let it be part of you and I. That when you don't do that, it's like, I know what I'm going to do. Say, it makes someone a candidate for hellfire. Just imagine the prisoner, Joshua. To him, that thought, I will make heaven. The unforgiveness just put what a filthy garment over his life.
Sir.
But after what? Take that thing out fast.
Dirty.
Imagine what happened. The body of Moses. That the founder of the church, God will send him back to reconcile with that person for him to make heaven.
Mm.
If he didn't send him back, that means the guy is doomed for hell.
How are you?
How come? Just one little forgiveness, just one little sin. You and I, we should always what? Say, Lord, whatever I've done wrong, I never fall short of forgiving. Have mercy. I'm sorry. Forgive me. And whosoever has fought me, I forgive that person also. I was watching a program and this man went to swim and was being beaten by a deadly fish or reptile in the river. So he was dying. So he was find someone to take him down to the hospital. The taxi driver he met didn't answer him very well. So he was bitter. So in his near-death experience, he remembered that he had not accepted Christ. So he had to what? In that spirit, he had to what? Repent. So God had to tell that people you have to forgive. And God had brought the tithing man's face to him. He said, ah, but at least, says, you have something against this man just now. So you have to what? Forgive the tithing driver. This was a near-death experience clip. They were just showing different people. That in that little church, why? Because the man didn't give him a good attention. He was angry. And he was dying. I'm going to say, ah, that man, you have to forgive that man. If not, you won't make it. So, unforgiveness makes someone a candidate for hell. But that will not be our portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, this is the medical power of faith. Unforgiveness classified in the medical books as a disease, according to Dr. Steele. He's a pastor, but he's a medical doctor. He did a research on it that all the cancer patients, that 61% of them have unforgiveness issues. That if they can be treated very well, they can have a forgiving heart. This thing no is. Now you see that cancer is on rampant. Why? Because of unforgiveness. You see, there's an attack. But deep down, it's unforgiveness that is causing it. Because men are born lovers of themselves. So you say, me, this to me, this to me. That bitterness, that unforgiveness leads to medical issues in the body, leads to what? Cancer. So we want to tell you that be cancer free, live a forgiving life. Pursue peace with all men. Please, you can see the Christ didn't say make peace with all men. In other words, no, sometimes just have to pursue peace with all men. Just make it a must. Just be at peace with all men. Be at peace with all men so that things will be well. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Pray after Jesus.
Amen.
So God wants you and I to what? To forgive. Christ said 70 times 7. So just for one day. And there's nobody has offended us up to 190 times. Just one evil issue that put you trapped for a longer period of time. Praise the Lord.
Is that for every single day? Or
every single day, yes.
What I love every single day.
Mm-hmm. And the poor have just one issue. Or at most three. They did this to me! You didn't greet me when you saw me. You didn't have a cultural thing that you didn't portray. How dare you? You small rats. You this. In that dynasty, they are still doing like that. Any question?
Yeah.